to the wind and just go for more of a pug-centric approach, because that could maybe catch Immortals off guard. But anyway, here we go into the first pistol. Cillian pulls that off, doesn't actually chime in with any bullets, just gets the information and backs away. Freeze will be there from the connector. And it seems that Immortals are going to still press onto the site, even though the information is gathered. It is a very easy site to get the bomb planted on the B side of training these pistols. But a beautiful couple of frags from Cillian and Valder as well is going to keep this retake alive for a few more moments. Showtime is there. Well, the standout players from Immortals actually qualifiers, but Moddy and Freeze put down frags with the USP. Now it's all on Bolts. He has the Molotov and there's no smoke in the hands of SK, so he could just bounce it off the wall. In fact, there is, pardon me, which has just been used from play. He was picked up from a corpse. So that Molotov completely useless, and Cillian lands the headshot. Easy first round, great retake.
Yeah, quite standard. Retaking on B is really easy, especially when you get those three kills that quickly. It was just boom, 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 lights out for SK in that round. And Immortals, after getting the bomb plant, keeping it 5v5, looked all right for a moment, but it doesn't work out in the end, and that's another pistol round lost to add to the statistic. That already looks bad on them.
However, even with having such a poor performance in terms of pistol rounds, they still were 3-for-3 with some pretty notable victories as well, so it seems it doesn't deter them too much. They still can bounce back with a vengeance, and Immortals will be stacking together, pushing in. If it's a little close driven and thrown that incendiary, that could have been complete catastrophe for Immortals, but instead, SK playing it slow. I guess we're going to have an explosion though, Wallace, pretty soon.
Yeah, the B site, obviously. These choke points, as you can see, very close to where you can actually just plant the bomb, so huge opportunity to just jump out and be able to do it without too much friction from the opposition, and still taking their time. The thing is, they can hold for flanks, but say they spot somebody, they're going to be pushed into hitting the site anyway. So, thankfully for them, SK haven't gotten frisky, aren't looking around too much. Or else, most likely, we'll just be able to get away with running in, but we'll have to dodge a P90 in the process.
Yeah, P90 almost tailor-made for this sort of position as well from Cillian. Not close to mid-range, against no armor, it will shred through Immortals if they push in. And judging from where the bomb is now residing, this is going to be a B hit. I thought maybe we'd see a fake through Pop Dog, but it's going to be the all-out charge. The mission is to get the bomb planted, and it seems that mission has been failed. Although Bolt is going to connect a headshot and a second as well onto Valt, so at least taking some weapons down with them. As expected, SK are there. They did lose three players in the process, which is more than they were going to hope for.
I'm quite curious what the thought process is with staying inside of Whitehall, waiting out your opponent without actually having any info on the other part of the map. I mean, if they stay and hold flanks and someone pushes, they don't even have a great advantage to get that kill. But not only that, they know that SK have so much information. So I wonder what the thought process is behind delaying a B take that long, and then ultimately just hitting it standard as if you would in the first few moments of the round.
So early buy up from Immortals as a result. Frags, the bomb plant in the first round. Moddy eats negligible damage from the grenade. The AOK to just hold his position for now. And Immortals will be filtering out. And it should be mentioned that SK have some pretty big results against the likes of Astralis. They actually beat them 16-6 in E-League, which is a pretty crazy score when you consider it's Astralis that they're up against.
Lucas actually made it out onto the site, but his teammate goes down and actually tries to get in. Cillian spotted him and fell off. That was a really nice play. Now Lucas gets shot in the side of the head and the bomb is down on the ramp upper.
Nice trade of frags for Immortals though. They will regain the player advantage. The bomb though is dropped in a really nasty position. Oh, Valder's played this one perfectly. You can see the Bolts has no idea at all if he can get put down. Bomb dropped again. Henny now going to have to make a move up. Pop Dog should be into the racing arms of Valder, but Sar gets the kill. He had no right to take that one down, and now Freeze in a 1v2 that should never be stacked against him. There's options for Immortals as well. You can see he's assuming he's going to be coming down Pop Dog, but actually, Henny's going to be taking it over on the B site. It's going to be a rough ask. He does have an incendiary and a smoke on the flash, but
bomb has been planted.
This would be a huge round for Immortals to pick up for themselves, early doors. Freeze will be moving in, misses the shot, probably cost him his life, and he's there to distribute the frag.
Jeez. You know, it does come down to that one frag. Henny getting that kill off of ladder, making it a 2v1 for Immortals when it could have been a 2v1 for SK. is clearly the most important trait of that round, and it comes down to someone falling off a ladder and getting a headshot. But ultimately, there were other moments in that round where SK could have actually had a bigger advantage. I think when Valdit had the flank on the player who picked up the bomb after he spotted it, he could have waited and actually had a full control moment, maybe gotten a 2-frag off of it, baited Immortals into hitting me right away. Instead, pulled the trigger, I think, a little bit too early. I feel like he's regretting that decision now.
It certainly was the key moment in Hot Dog. And as a result, now SK, from a fairly commanding position, into the kill on Eco, in the pure sense of the term, as well as full USP, no grenades, nothing else to play with. And yet one kill out the round, but that's it. So Immortals bounce right back, and you know, they're talking about the player to watch out for. Henny was eerily absent, actually, throughout the entire qualifiers, but especially on train. It's a map where he normally tees off, he has crazy reaction speed, and it allows for his aggressive warping to take hold, but he's definitely one player that I'll be keeping an eye on to see if he does perform today, because they missed him.
Train is so critical because you can stay at Ivy and be responsible for 3 choke points within a moment's notice, so.
This result's going straight out though. Hungry for blood, ruthless aggression. Up until the moment, the flashbang pretty much put a red light in his face. Freezer Valder gonna make the most of this one. Henny will get back though. Up close for the pop flash. Is he gonna be good for this frag? Is he gonna be spying through the smoke? Get it done, and now gets picked off from Glaive. So both the stand-ins have done their job for this round. And it falls to Bolts in a 1-on-4. This would be such a stinging round for Immortals to lose. They knew that SK would be in the force. Poor amount of weaponry. Bolts will not get any more out this round, and SK have stabilized.
Yep, they do it. Versus the explosive A-take from Immortals, which sometimes it can feel like an all-in when you try to do it. You say, this is going to hit them really hard. They're not going to expect it. We're going to get our 2 or 3 kills immediately, close out the round. They're not going to know what hit them. Well, instead, SK deal with the pressure quite well. And now Immortals, if they go back to a slow pace round, it might be a little bit of an anticipated move, and maybe will make them question whether or not they made the right decision previously. Wow, nice pick from Henny, though, to open it up. 5v4 now.
Those are the kind of picks that I was talking about. Those are the kind of picks that Henny was not landing at the qualifiers. So if he starts to tee off, then Immortals for me will be a force to be reckoned with. Glaive dead and buried, momentarily silenced. We'll see him reemerge in round 7, but the question is, what will the score be? Will SK be able to extend their lead once again to 2 rounds? Immortals only have a Tech 9 on Lucas, but with that first pick, that alleviates so much of the pressure and the presence on the board of SK. And they may be forced into some kind of aggressive play, and that's what's going to happen here. The pop flash goes in, but it wasn't on point, and Phelps will take that free kill all day long. The second kill comes in right behind him. Immortals are just locking this round down. Estillion can do nothing. What a take that ended up being on A.
Yeah, that was a very fundamentally played round from both sides. I mean, the op getting its pick on T side, critically important, obviously, for Immortals. Henny makes that happen. And then they move towards outside, and because they're in their default, slow it down to the point that they cause SK to try to push, right? Expected from the team that's down a man to try to look even up. And Immortals, because they were in their default, were able to capitalize on that push, and that is what spurred them to actually push out and continue the A-take. So, well played from Immortals. It's the perfect thing to do, right? Get your kill, then slow it down. Wait for the opponent to push. The opponent pushes. You get that frag, and then you close it out. And it will be with 4 alive. It looks a little bit questionable for a moment in that duel.
I think both players will be a bit red-faced at the moment, but it did go the way of Immortals, so back to a quality we move. The question has been answered. SK will not be extending their lead. In actual fact, I feel like their economy is in tatters again. Mm-hmm. It's been ebbing and flowing, but that's going to favor the terrorists more often than not, because of course, getting those weapons is so much cheaper. And again, full-on safe from SK.
Now, Showtime is probably the man to watch here. He's going to be the heat-seeking missile. They're going to probably want to get as many kills into him as possible because he has that MAC-10, and there's the first one.
I feel like there's no real hope of SK getting anything out of this round. They do get at least a kill with them, but that's going to be all she wrote. No, a second kill. Bolts get caught. It's caught for money. SK do not have an AK to work off. That's smoke. They knew exactly where he was. Very isolated position. And Immortals will take the lead.
Really threaded the needle on that one from what looked like E-Box. And now we're in a spot where I think It's most certainly going to be a buy. Most players from SK almost down to zero. Down around and have picked up and off in the hands of three. So now, will he go toe-to-toe with Henny? I doubt it. But will he be aggressive? I hope to expect to see that because, again, mobility a huge factor in whether or not your offer is good and Valda goes down, or actually gets a frag, excuse me, onto Phelps. That's a big one.
Now one of the key members of Immortals has been put down. But the problem for SK is even though they get the first kill, which obviously is a massive plus, they just don't have that many grenades to use. And I'll be half a mind, when do we use them? You know, do they want to try and fend off the initial charge? Do they want to use them on the retake? This could funnel them into aggressive plays, and that's how their defense collapsed a few rounds ago when Valda tried to push into team main and the flash didn't work. So Immortals, yes, they're a player down, but they still have quite a bit of control.
With ladder control, we see the obvious A split coming out. You can tell by where the bomb is positioned. The smoke's going to be cascading over the site, and the split comes out.
Smoke's down, flashes as well. Wave is on top of this. He sensed that the push was imminent. Hold this position perfectly, but now Mortals are deciding, okay, screw this, let's just rush to B instead. Henny opens up with the AWP, but it's going to be all on a ceiling after field, and he catches Bolts with his pants down and will take down the frag. Henny now gets caught, failing with two consecutive UMP kills. Very well played. A solid round for SK.
It initially seemed like an outer take was imminent, but they had the bomb rotate from T-Con all the way to inner. And I guess they could have potentially caused rotates out of the B site completely. I mean, it's not uncommon to see a team evacuate that site because it is so easy to retake. But instead, we had a man posted at schools, didn't move a muscle, so. I think Immortals at the very least assume that you have someone in Z in a rotator spot, but not someone dedicated that close up in the site, so very good on SK to not rotate in that situation.
Immortals actually go for a double AWP pickup in a round where they were low on economy, and Phelps very nearly connects that shot, but instead just dropped down to 13. So on the receiving end of a battery, well, it looked like maybe he would be the one to pull the trigger and break the deadlock. Glaive, this is going to be a pure timing play. If he gets up, this could be completely disgusting for Immortals, and it looks like he's going to get at least one kill. He's going to get a second, no. Showtime will even the odds, but the damage has been inflicted elsewhere on Immortals as well. Henny's down 51, although Phelps will take down the frag, so he's keeping the dream alive for Immortals to regain the lead again. Very spread attack, though, for Immortals, but they have the time to play with.
Freeze has got to have impact quickly. Ops getting kills around him is inexcusable without him being able to get a frag to answer back, though. It was his teammates to be a little bit aggressive, and that's why they went down. And now the three players of SK, all committed to outside, have a lot of coverage here, though it seems Immortals are going to be focusing their talents on B. Huge problem for SK. Well, wow. And Phelps, 10 HP after missing his first frag, comes away with two core kills.
Crazy. SK, I feel like this round was theirs. It was begging to be taken, but instead it is slipping away ever so quickly. Acilian has to try and hold this down. If he can pick up a kill or two, it would be massive for his team. There's the first one. The time is ticking low, but the bomb is about to be planted. Immortals, oh, Acilian comes in for a second. Is he going to land a third? So close onto Bolster, but he's brung this back to a 1v1. And there's Freeze from behind.
Wow.
Acilian take a bow. That was all his doing.
Wow. And that was three players from SK on the wrong site, down a man to win on the retake. I mean, that bomb barely got planted. They were fortunate enough to do that, and the cleanup just came out immediately. Nice hold from Acilian, well played from him to get that first frag, and also have so much patience on killing the player defending the planter. I mean, that was really nice from him. I mean, just to stay alive on the B site is a credible enough effort to talk about, but to get a couple of kills in the process as well means the world to your team on CT. And now, Acilian is going to be picking up an auto sniper just to pat himself on the back. And he's got a lot weaker opponents coming at him. Actually, I mean, there could have been an eco to come up, so spending this much money on an auto sniper might be a little bit of a liability. But, I mean, it slows down the retake a little bit, but there's also more potential for huge damage on the initial execute.
Oh, for sure. And seeing as Acilian's by and large been doing the business with assault rifle UMP, this now pushes him into a different play style. He now has to play more passive and a deeper defense on the site. So This is where smokes and flashes really come good as well. Yeah. I do worry a little bit for SK. I completely agree. This could be a liability now for SK. Because Immortals have, more often than not, looked too aggressive to be. And this is the situation I'm talking about. Let's see if we can pick them on the cross. There's the first one, and it is going to be complete mode down. They're not using their smokes or flashes. Immortals will get punished. There's Bolt back with an AK frag, and Bolts as well. Oh my goodness, this can't be happening, ST. You've just lost four players in a row. It's all on Moddy. This was a gimme round after those first two frags. Nice shot onto Phelps, but two more to find. And he's about to get flanked from behind. Penny is in hot pursuit. He's going to turn back around again and get picked off. How did SK lose after the auto sniper frag?
I have no idea how that's even possible. I mean, the fact that we had four players rotating through Z, even after Path was smoked, and then still dying before able to get to new positions, like, how the meta of that round's supposed to play out is the bomb goes down, if no kills come out, someone pushes down the site, right, then trades start happening up close to Z, but everyone gets out of Z. That's kind of step one, and they couldn't do that. So, I mean, because they died, there's no surprise they lost that round, but what a round to lose. Gave up the auto. Such an expensive round. And it was versus a force up from Immortals.
Yeah. It was like four AKs, maybe a Glil thrown in with a Tech 9.
Glil and a Tech 9, yeah.
Not too great at all. And now, SK, don't just lose the round. They're now in an eco. Phelps just looks straight at him.
And Freeze gets a kill off of that. Oh
is
my
Freeze
God.
A chameleon? Just blending in with the surroundings. Phelps is like, that's a weird looking train. No way, it's an enemy. Awkward. Moddy now, USP. For all those shenanigans, the Immortals will still grasp onto this round very comfortably.
Oh, Moddy had such a good feeling that someone was posted up on him. And will he win this duel? No, Henny. Blood red from head to toe. Comes away with one or two HP, I think.
It's those moments you wish you had a P250 or a 5.7.
Right.
Here we go. Phelps is like, ugh. Nope. Didn't see anything. Okay.
4-3 Kappa.
Brilliant. Can you imagine Bolt's reaction? He's like, dude, what the hell was that? How did I just die from behind?
Bolt's like, I'm a good person. Why did this just happen to me?
That's a matchmaking moment. Either way, Immortals are the result of winning the last round. But SK took the mass. Next course, no AWP in play. Many grenades either. And to make matters worse, Phelps and Showtime have teed off with two opening picks. That's been so rough for SK, who so long we're looking in command, but now the blink of an eye, it's back to a 3-on-3, albeit on a retake, and Henny's in the perfect position to strike. He's actually shot prematurely. This is the second shot as well. Showtime will do the business with his AK. Come on, Henny. Come on, Henny, please.
Fifth time's a charm.
Terrorists win.
That's the write-off. That's the write-off. They still win the round, right? What's interesting to me is how many times that Tempo, or whoops, Immortals, are committing so much attention to outside and then actually just giving SK the runaround, hitting the B site. I mean, using that many resources on a site that, I guess, B is such an easy site to fake, right, because people will give it up. So it's kind of interesting to me to see so many resources being used on a site that it should be easy to cause retakes, rotates without that.
Another eco from SK, and looks like it's going to be a carbon copy of the other times. Immortals will just be putting their foot to the throat of SK and taking this one comfortably off the judge. Like Moddy, accompanied by a Cillian and Freeze, they try and push up behind, but it's only delaying the inevitable. Showtime chilling in the bathroom. Oh! Get wrecked. That's what they were looking for. It's a nice little dosage of money and also the AK as well. Now Cillian, the backstabber. The last remaining counter-terrorist. Pop flashing through into Pop Dog. Two players in there. It's a flash as well, and Phelps picks him off through the wall into the head. And Immortals will take a convincing lead now on that B side.
I wonder actually what that kill does for their economy moving into this round. Maybe it's not a situation where without this $1,500 right here off the knife in the back, there may not be an op, and I think Freeze, actually with a little bit of money remaining, it might have made the difference. I'd actually see if a drop happened or not, but they do have that ever important op. A single player inside, I'm just shoulder spotting. Vasilian drops his smoke instantly. And again, SK right now are conditioned to expect an outer take that turns into a fake. I wonder what that means if Immortals decide to smoke Elder and then hit it as well. Mahdi, though, having Ivy control, also has some peace of mind. Sharing this info with his teammates is enormous.
Yeah, this allows him to keep two players on B, because they know the A hit is going to be very one-dimensional, should be able to be fended off. They also have Valda, who's in the connector side of A, so he can quickly wrap himself around and be that third almost sweeper role. That being said, Immortals aren't going to put some doubts in the minds. Maybe trying to push out, Clay lands the headshot. This is a great round so far for SK, shaping up perfectly. And there's Freeze, and this is really all off to the result of Mahdi going for that push and finding the information, but SK, convincing round. I don't think they lost a single point of health.
Yeah, it was awesome, and I think it was partly due to the confidence they had that it was going to be their site. And if it wasn't, that they knew, okay, if a split comes out Elder, at most, it's going to be T-Con and Ladder, right? We don't have to worry about Ivy. We also have a player that can fake flank T-Con. And so I think they were just very comfortable with the amount of information they had that allowed them to focus. And, you know, Acilian, even versus the fakes and everything, has been able to get two kills in a round. I mean, he's been doing solid on B. And there's a really important opening track. Wait, looks for a second one. Wow. Showtime gets decapitated on his way down.
A little surprised that Showtime would just run straight through. No one knows a player there.
Yeah,
maybe
no trade.
Maybe go for the surprise attack.
I was making a bit of an assumption there that, yeah. Oh, you know, the kill came out. Maybe this guy goes out, reloads. Dead now and off an AK down. SK up 5-3 in terms of players.
Looking good for SK in the final round of the half. Molts have seen this before. They went for a pop flash into a push, but this time SK decided not to pull the trigger. Second flash goes off. Again, not pushing in.
Oh, he's Henning. So close to seeing the head of his opponent
can
there.
See just a millimeter.
Oh my god.
Shows and Henny converts it. Glaive, the man with the opening two picks, has been put to bed for this half at least. Great shot. Oh, what will that mean for the remainder of this round? A round that SK desperately need to get their hands on. Freeze, the next to fall, interestingly enough, actually out in the open without any crossfire. Gives his life away, and that's a crucial kill, especially considering that Acilian is low. Henny misses the shot. He does get vital information. 22 seconds left. They're going to have to start to make a push for the A site. Get this bomb down. Valda finally picks up bolts, but a bit too late for Mahdi. And he misses another one, but Acilian by himself. Charging through the smoke, using that flashbang. A 2-on-1. We've seen him play pretty solid so far for SK, but he's made noise now. And he will get picked off from Lucas. SK will not be getting them themselves the seventh round, but that shot from Henny, though.
Yeah, that shot from Henny. I mean, both those kills, really good kills. And the funny part is that Henny actually missed a lot that round and yet probably had the most impact of anyone, right? And that just means that he's looking in all the right spots. I mean, he's being a very good, or very big asset to his team. And just being able to spot that is so good. That opening kill allows his teammates to know that here's a player down dedicated to A. We know we can take the site. Makes it a lot easier, less angles to clear, and so on. So. Really nice half from Immortals overall. Very dominant round they did win, a couple of them. SK should have almost certainly been able to claw their way back into, but couldn't. And are only left with six on their CT side.
Start to see Train edge towards the T side a little bit more recently, where a lot of T sides will pick up a whole bunch of rounds. So yeah. I definitely wouldn't write off SK. My worry and concern for them is with two people stepping in, on fairly short notice, what are their T-strats going to be like? Is it going to be more of a pug-centric charge? Are we going to see many strats implemented from SK here? There are a couple of doubts in my mind, but let's see how this one plays out. Second half is starting. SK desperately need this pistol.
So they typically, SK, play very slow on T-side on Train. They focus a lot on IV control, but they default very heavily and they wait out time quite a bit. I wonder if anything changes, considering the fact that they've got two new members here. Ooh, that's a good nade.
Hello.
Oof, that's a really good nade.
That's gonna sting, especially as Freeze seems to be the allocated player to try and cause nuisance from Team A. That's gonna definitely put him on the back seat. And here comes Phelps, though. It actually has a chance to reload in amongst the smoke. Lives to fight another day. He tapped left, right, and center. Valda decides, okay, I'm gonna push through myself. Something done. for it yourself. Now Valda has been put down, leaving Freeze in a 1-on-2, but only 31 health left. He's about to get picked off from behind. Or is he? Vault misses out on a few shots, a few more.
He gets picked off.
Not like this.
And Showtime Solo, gets the- Freeze gets the clutch. Oh, Bolts.
Oh no. Bolts is just face test.
If you could pick your own crossfire, right, on any map, in any situation, how much better of a crossfire could that have been than to have both sides of the angle cut off by two people and still miss the frag? And Freeze with one HP gets the clock, 1v2, oh my gosh.
Yeah. How important could that moment be in the grand scheme of this map? Yes, SK is still up against it, yes, they're struggling. But that kind of clutch can inspire players. Plus the fact that now buys them another lifeline back into Trey. That is going to be discouraging, to say the least, for Immortals if SK can bring this back to 9-9.
That certainly stings. Well, you can't ever ask or expect an ego to be converted, but if there ever a situation, now would be the time.
10 out of 10 for the backflip, Bolts. Nice nade from Moddy.
9 out of 10 for the dismount, though.
Won't be getting up anytime soon. The Immortals did go for a force, so they've committed heavily into this round with Deagles. They've got Kevlar as well. A kit stacking on the B side with just Phelps, who's watching from Pop Dog. So SK, with the information they've been given from that first kill, positional advantage, their weaponry advantage. Lower still, he gets caught! And he's gonna get picked off in the meatball store to Showtime. He gets himself a frag. SK are laboring their way towards converting this round, but again, it's been so close. You still fancy to get this 3-on-3, because the MAC-10's been picked up for Immortals for Showtime, and he will be ripped off from Freeze. Players will be coming from the backside of the trade from CT. Lucas tries his hand with a few opening deeks and will be repelled in kind. Pushed off the silk from Valda, all on Henny. He's been spotted. Surely his days are numbered. P250 is all he has. He's survived much longer than I would have thought he had. But 9-8 the score regardless.
Whatever spawned that decision to rotate to the outer side, I'm not sure what piece of information set them off, but it was a good one, and hitting outer in that moment made a lot of sense. Now, SK could have brought that round a lot closer, could have come down to a 1v1 if they went to B, and instead they kept three alive, so very good cleanup from them. Get around that looked a little sketchy. So funny when you see Phelps coming up that ladder, and with that deagle, and you spawn someone, you know you gotta get up the ladder to start shooting, but that means you have to aim off them, and that's what's so awkward.
Money should be in the money. Three kills, MAC-10. Money in the bank.
MAC Daddy.
Certainly is. Henny and Phelps again have the difficult task of taking anybody down. More of a mistake they have to feel from SK than they play from Immortals to win from this point. He is as clear cut around as he could ask for. SK will be picking up the ninth. Did do quite a bit of damage to a few players, but 9-9.
Yeah, that becomes a situation where you literally have to pre-fire to be able to hit a shot. And Phelps abusing that mechanic. I mean, that's how you have to play in those situations. So, got some good damage in. No kill, but it's tied up. Immortals now moving into their first rifle round versus SK on CT side. Quite telling for them. And we see Glaive hanging on to this UMP, and that's because it's so good that you can hang on to it. If you lose the round, you have a rebuy for next, and you have a great opportunity to either get a kill or pick up an AK from a teammate who have died, so.
Yeah. Plus with the UMP as well, he must know that Immortals wouldn't have had a great deal of economy, so probably skimped out on head armor because it does nothing against the AKs. So UMP has good armor penetration and can still rip the head off shoulders. This is still a very potent, viable weapon in this circumstance for SK. Not worth throwing the money away either. Cillian taking a leaf out of Phelps' book, who consistently pushed from this kind of position. Speaking of the man Phelps, he is gridlocked down in the smoke and coming around in the back of them. There's the first spray in the second. Big plays from the Brazilian, and now he's in a position to strike again, single-handedly taking this round away from SK. Weasel Moddy have their work cut out for them. Make that just Moddy. We've seen him doing good work with the Mac 10. Is he able to rinse and repeat with the AK? Spotting two players. Nice shot onto Phelps. He doesn't have the bomb, but it's in a position that immortals don't know of. So for all he knows, they... Oh, I was going to say for all they know he does, but it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Nearly. Very close.
Yeah, quite close indeed. Oh, Mahdi, very, very good aim. I mean, definitely I'd say best on the team. And here's Phelps with just superior positioning. I mean, not more to say. Actually getting three kills off of that too. And that was waiting for a third member to peek him. He got what he wanted. But abusing the SK smoke there, basically telegraphing the play and seeing, all right, once the smoke goes down, I know they're going to try to split outer through the right. I'm going to wait behind them and then take advantage of the fact that I know exactly what they're going to do. Right? They're telling me what I'm going to do.
Oh, Phelps. Look how aggressive this is. And if he plays this perfectly, he could have a hat full of kills. The first one down, the second. And he's going to be looking for a third. Just about misses out, but the information and the damage done to Glaive in the meanwhile from Henny on Ivy just makes this such a sweet round for Immortals. After losing four, they weren't into a great buy this round either. SK actually had the better weaponry.
Well, off of the fast flank, and you know, that's a situation where you wish you just had a bigger gun to take advantage of what you see in front of you. But getting the two kills in the first place is more than good enough. Also doing damage there, I think, to Glaive, so. Now SK, have just been caught with their pants down. And have decided to instead, look for new information. Henny, though, because his teammate was hurt, or because Glaive was hurt, excuse me, gets away with a one-shot kill off a scout.
Damage to Henny himself inflicted earlier. And Lucas with a quick-fire double spray. SK now backed against the wall. Looks like the Immortals have been able to get through the worst of it. This is the Phelps play. Very nearly gets a third. Did about 28 damage, I think, to Asilian overall, but great play all the same. And that's just off. I mean, he has some serious balls, let's be honest.
Yeah, I mean,
he just... players would go for that.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he just picked the spot. And he's like, I'm going to push ladder this round.
Yeah.
Not only that, but I'm going to do it right away, right? So, wasn't looking for any information, was going purely off a read, and it paid off in dividends. I wonder how many times you can get away with that, but ultimately it's resulted in a save, so.
Whoops. A bit awkward, but information has been gathered. Showtime will dust himself off. The thing is, though, even though this information has been gathered, they've used a lot of utility for this initial charge, and SK could very well just back away and go down Pop Dog. There's no guarantee that they will charge on to B, and I think that's why Phelps is going up for this. He wants to get the info for himself, see firsthand what's coming up against them, and now the floodgates have opened. But Immortals have put down a dam. That being said, Moddy is a one-man wrecking crew, two frags for him. But the PT-50 has kept this round alive for a few more seconds. Phelps now going to go for his timing double spray. You've got to say, Immortals' timing is on point so far today.
This is why Vendetta shouted out Phelps there on the desk. I mean, this is it. Like, he is just playing with so much confidence right here. Positionally is on point, and not only that, but he's getting multi-kills every single round. Well, the bomb does sneak by. Little chance here for Freeze, who has no armor to make anything of this round. But maybe might be able to get away with a kill.
He's playing so well. So incredibly well. As soon as he comes up, though, he is a guy, and you can understand why he went for the play to get on top of the train. It gave him the best chance of maybe getting a kill or two. Phelps with four kills in that round.
Phelps is in such a good place mentally, you can tell. He's just playing with so much confidence. Everything he's doing, he's getting away with, and it's because he has just such a good beat on what's going on. And not only that, he's hitting all his shots, getting more kills than he's supposed to every single round. So he didn't fall off up there. He just waited for the perfect moment to re-aggress, and it wasn't just because he felt like being aggressive. Already up to 26 kills, like, yeah, that was a 4K on an eco, but did you see each of those kills? Those were smart.
And even without padding his stats in the eco round, he still hit 20 bomb comfortably, yeah. So he has been the determining factor. He has been what's kept Immortals afloat.
No damage dealt, not correct.
That's unfortunate. Saw the player, didn't manage to get anything done. Also got turned up a tiny bit from the incendiary that flew his way down to 91. Henny now is going to feel the burn. Henny, get out of there. He loses 58 health. That's a rough chain of events for Immortals. But then again,
and he has the AWP. Doesn't matter if you have 100 health or 10, you can still make it work. Just position yourself properly. It'll be easy pickings. Looks like it's going to be a set play here, Lord Zinta A. Or is it going to just be a fake?
Well, we've seen that before, and it looks like, yeah, T-Con is the motive.
And he has landed the first shot, just speaking before that. No matter how much he's carrying, they line up for Lucas, but he will get put down from Valda. And now that affords SK the chance to push through onto the site. The bomb's just behind Valda in the very capable hands of Glaive. He's going to be planting green train side.
Bomb has been
in the meanwhile. Maybe the duel to the death with Penny, who snaked his way around. Misses the shot! Does get the second one, the much harder of the two, and then very nearly spanks another player through the smoke. That's going to be Valda who takes out Bolt. That in a nutshell is Henny. He's such an exciting player to watch, but so frustrating at the same moment. And now Mori comes around from the back and Showtime's been put down. Immortals, who looked like they were going to finally cruise towards this victory, then brought back a couple of pegs.
Yeah, cool. It was a cool pincer move there. We saw similar play from Immortals in the first half, but instead of turning it into some type of fake, they decided to run right out T-Con, made the frags happen, and ultimately put a round on the board. It's Immortals now who have what looks like a very tattered buy, have actually opted to put all their money into ops, two ops right now.
Yeah, we've seen them do it from the T side as well. They like to go for this pick central composition. If it works, you look like a genius. If it doesn't, you just get slaughtered. That's the problem. There's so much pressure now on Phelps and Henning.
Oh, he saw it coming. I don't know if he was completely cognizant of it, but I think it was called out that they have been making this play almost every round, and oh, they're getting very aggressive, but not getting paid off.
Oh, Phelps can't see a single thing. The snowstorm descends in Glaive. All sweep him aside. Bolts now, trying to get those 1Ds into effect, but greeted by fire.
Wow, see how many hoops they had to jump through just to neutralize Phelps there, but they played it perfectly, right, every single time.
Herein lays the issue with both the double op setup. They now have very little weaponry to work off. No real grenades other than incendiary. It's just been thrown out from Showtime. A flash that's still in the back pocket of any on his utility belt. Lucas is about to get aggressed on the smoke. Will save his life. They could line up for him. One kill. No, doesn't actually get it. There's a team kill from Glaive onto Ithilien. Lucas did the damage beforehand. A bit of confusion for a few moments. Showtime.
Bomb has been
planted. Forward to 5-7.
We have got to call the buy in the question, right? What was the strategy behind it? And not to say that it wasn't justifiable, but that it seems like once everything is done and dusted, that it's hard to see what Immortals were going for and how they planned to make the impact of the ops. How they planned to make an impact of the ops. Now, it did seem like Phelps had the opportunity to frag there. He's very close to it. And we didn't have eyes on Henny, so there might have been more to the round than we see by the results. But ultimately, you know, it's resulted in Immortals saving right now when this could have been a buy and they could have had maybe half armor, a couple of grenades last round. A good chance to win it, but a good chance to do damage and then a great chance to win it.
They're biting off more than they could chew. Now, will be another full on eco. This time, the Angel Immortals. We saw this a couple times from SK on the CT side. Mac 10 for Moddy has called this perfectly in terms of the economic situation. And last time he had a Mac 10, he got a triple kill from a similar position actually on the ramp. So he will take point for his team. Again, it's an expendable weapon. No huge deal if he loses it. SK not going to give anything away for free. Not when they're breathing down the necks of Immortals now. Into the next round of Immortals. He's pulling a trigger with a buy, but the question is, make it work. Moddy's already pushed all the way through onto the CT spawn, and now the heavy stack of CT members will be coming through connector. Glaive is there, there'll be a crossfire down if he waits any longer. Here comes Moddy from the back. How many frags can he pick up for himself? Is this going to be the one for now, because the CTs have split up? Moddy could be walking right into a trap. He's not going to expect the player behind. There's going to be Bolt. He's tapping away. And then he spins around. Again, you wish for any weapon other than the USP there.
Yeah.
Unfortunate, but 12-12.
The job is done. Just a textbook scout there from Moddy. Use your $1,000 weapon to go and get info on a site. Maybe get a kill or two, but first and foremost, make sure that it's not the stacked spot. And even if it is, you only give up the MAC-10 and then have your teammates in position to either hit it right behind you or be ready to go to the other site. And that's what happened there. Moddy scouted it out, didn't see anything. Gave his teammates information. They went and won the round.
Phelps, what can you get done? You're the top fragger. He just saw the arms leaping around the wall. He wasn't expecting a triple stack. Walked into a firing squad. And it's freeze. He leapfrogs forward another kill. And that's a big passage of play as well. Not only is it a weakened CT side, but it is the top fragger, the man in form of Phelps.
Phelps is absolutely getting ahead of himself some of these times. And it's only easy to say that because he's not getting the frags, but to make another solo push and not have anything to show for it is kind of questionable. And there's a second frag to follow up. And again, that second frag, much easier to get when it's 5-4, so.
Much more difficult for models to set down successful crossfires. But hold the phone for a second, because Henny has put down Glaive, although eats a grenade right afterwards. Glaive did a lot of damage before falling. No free frags today for Immortal. This is going to be a whole lot worse. Lucas, what could he get done with the M4? First frag goes his way. The bomb now on the A side. This will be coming through. Freeze misses his opportunity. And how costly will that prove to be for SK? The bomb will be getting planted momentarily. Lucas relocating. Actually, Acilian decides to fake it instead. He's waiting for the push. And this is giving Lucas a chance to relocate in close enough proximity. This could catch SK off guard. If they're not careful, Lucas could clutch this very easily. You're coming up from Ivy side now. And judging from the positions of SK, I was about to say they didn't have the crossfire down, but he's made movements, he's made noise, lands the frag onto Acilian. There's so many positions though, that's why it's a nightmare to retake on A that he has to cover from. And he doesn't have a kit either, so it's an easy peek, but Freeze actually misses the shot. It doesn't seem like it's going to matter. There's not enough time, but he gets charged down.
And that's it. Wow.
But if Lucas has a kit there, that would have been such a horrific round from SK.
Yeah, he could have won that. That's very true. I mean, that was extremely close. Now, it doesn't happen. And again, I'm just the entire round, just going over the moments here in these last couple where Phelps has given up the opening kill really early on without a trade, right? And it's versus the Ivy control of SK both times. Now, SK, if they really want Ivy and they send three people there, they're gonna get it. And if they go 4v4, they're gonna be completely fine with it. So you have to wonder, what's Phelps doing there alone? If he gets the kill and he goes 1-for-1, they don't come out ahead. They're on TP side, they've won most of their rounds. He's a very important person to have late to the round. Why risk him like that? I mean, he got away with it when, you know, it was that UMP push-up ladder. But that's a UMP, right? To do with the op, it seemed like, yeah, he saw an opportunity, okay. But to go to Ivy again, when SK are playing it extremely passively, taking all the necessary precautions, and then just trying to get in their face with one rifle and no flash, it makes you wonder, is he feeling himself too much?
It's very possible.
Is he really feeling himself?
It's possible. But the only thing I can think of is that the rest of his team had such a lack of utility that maybe he felt pressured to make a play. He was like, if we stall this out, they set play, we have nothing to stop the push. We didn't really have that many weapons. I think they had a FAMAS maybe in one of their hands.
Right.
So maybe that's the reason why, but I agree. You know, pushing by yourself, even if it is a 1-for-1 trade, that still favors the terrorists.
Yeah.
Especially when you're top fragging and you're playing like a monster. Like, you need to be the player that's in the middle of the rounds, dictating the pace and like really capitalizing on mistakes from this game.
No, but absolutely a good point. If you're low utility, that's a not desperation. It's just a smart thing to do because you're so low to try to get an advantage in terms of frags as opposed to play the tactical advantage of like waiting out time. But you know, just to spend $200 or $300 to make that push that much more effective, or even commit two people to it instead, may be a better option for them. But ultimately Phelps needs to be the one to stay alive. Like, we saw how powerful he was when they actually took Ivy and they came up. He stood behind that smoke. He got three frags off of that because of his great positioning, right? And even though his aim is on point, he's so much more valuable, I think, as a thinking player. And they're kind of using him as a mad fragger. But it might be his own decision, right? Maybe it's him just saying, like, I can do this, I can get away with this.
And perhaps that's what they're discussing right now. You know, do we just slow it down a little bit? Do we play a bit more smart? Lucas has the M4, the rest of the team pretty much filtering with nothing. Keep in mind that SK have picked the perfect moment to start to make a comeback. Not only are they 30-12 in the lead, but this is an eco by and large from Immortals, so they win this. They're just a couple of steps away from an upset, and I think it's fair to say this would be a pretty big upset. SK would not have been favored for many people to take this match, especially with two standings.
You'd have to be crazy to have bet on SK.
Yeah.
I'll say that.
pretty much. But it looks like they are in the position to make some magic happen. That being said, Immortal still with this high up, and after the tactical pause, still going to be very much a contender in this round. Super split approach from SK. Two players IV, one going around team main, the other two filtering out around Pop Dog, just making sure the Immortals don't push up anywhere on the back. So very reminiscent of how Nip were playing the cash T side, just effectively saying, come at us, bros. You don't have much. You know that if we execute, we're going to take you down. You have to make some moves.
Moment there where Freeze took a spot of damage. I think they are a little bit worried about a push coming out. Maybe not quite so aware that Immortals are as broke as they are, but either way, looks like they're going to 4-1 inner versus one person that's Showtime. P250 to his name.
Surely not much health. There we go. Put down. No damage inflicted apart from 8 onto 3. Well, now watching. Making sure everyone wraps around the back of SK. Bolt's the only player to chime in with a frag. Phelps is in a position that could yield some results in terms of frags. And is he going to go for the knife? Well, we're going to have the second knife. And is he going to go for the knife on Freeze? He's scampering away now. Oh, he doesn't want to make any noise. That's got to be butt-clenchingly frustrating.
No, you can. There's a piece of garbage there you can fall on.
Oh. Not that one, though. But Freeze hasn't heard it. He's about to get shanked. Oh, he turns around and still gets killed. Oh. I think for a second there, Phelps' heart skipped a beat. He thought he missed his chance.
Yeah, if he actually had a kit, he could have just jumped down and defused that. Yeah. The player's quite far away.
In fairness, though, to Phelps, not only does he get a knife, which obviously boosts his economy, but he keeps an AWP. So this bolsters the buy now, the CTs.
Yeah, incredibly so. That's the most salient point there. And we have a Tron cosplay. Very cool.
Oh, man. Phelps.
That's a giant pickup, yeah, definitely. I mean, wow. Instead of just taking that off and maybe getting another one, they've also put an auto sniper on the board. So this, if anything, will slow them down, right? I mean, whether they like to or not, they've put on the lead boots. This is just, they don't have many options to be too aggressive. And, you know, to give up their riflers, who are essentially supporting their oppers right now, would be a huge mistake.
Well, at this point, it's pretty much just a turret defense.
Yeah.
But for Immortals, they can't afford to play aggressively at all. The retakes are going to be really rough. On top of that, auto sniper double up composition of retakes just not going to happen, more than likely. So it's do or die.
Yeah, when SK win, they win Ivy. And it seems like here, not sure what the idea was. They went for that run boost again, maybe to cause Immortals to react to it, but have completely forfeited anybody over there. And I think it's because they've done such a good job of getting that kill now that they feel like they don't have to spend players watching it. And oh, the corner of the smoke. Such a powerful spot for Lucas. I'm not kidding.
Health power smoke. From SK going down. The bombs are getting planted as well. Phelps looking for the nose scope. You know, it's the hit. Bomb was planted just on the cusp of the train. 5-on-4 retake, and this is where the Ops and Auto Sniper Rifle could very well falter. It's going to be Bolt with his M4. What can he get done? He got a frag just before falling, and Valder's there as well, and that's all on Phelps. They committed so many funds into this round. He's got to run with his P250 as a result of having the AWP. Player goes past him. What can he get done? Valder picks him off. You can see what he was going for, but Fry comes in nonetheless. 15-12, 3 match points for SK Gaming, and it's not going to be a great buy for Immortals here either.
My goodness, and Valder, the new guy on the team.
Actually, better than
out.
I thought it would be, fair enough.
What's that?
Better than I thought it would be.
Oh, really? Yeah, I mean, yeah. But, still two ops. I don't even know how that's possible, but maybe it's because of that pickup, right? Saving the op in that previous round.
Yeah.
Bolstered him so much. The knife kill as well, funnily enough. And, but Valder getting the 3K entry. Lucas had such a good spot, and oh, there's one round where they don't run boost over Ivy and actually get punished for it. So I guess they were surprised to see that it wasn't Immortals to try to pick the boost. Instead, they just picked the cross and have been rewarded. So Immortals calling them out for trying to condition them. And now for once in such a long time, I have to say, have gotten the opening frag. 5v4 for Immortals, but 15-12 for SK. I mean, I don't want to say they have rounds to work with, but they have got to be more comfortable than their opponents in this situation.
Oh, absolutely. See now, playing every second at their disposal. You're not going to be pulling the trigger too early. You're not going to be giving away anything for free. I feel like it's going to be a set play onto A. They're throwing two smokes over one connector. One to the side of the bomb. In the meanwhile, though, bomb is still up around Pop Dog, so this looks like it's going to be a fake to me. Yeah, this is going to be a fake. They're throwing the smokes onto the site, trying to keep all the vision away while they simultaneously push into the B site. The problem is it's a 2-on-2, and Immortals haven't bought this fake at all. The bomb's dropped in a horrible place. The flashes are going to keep the remaining SK members at bay. And Immortals have held on. You have to assume from this point they don't lose. So SK, back to the drawing board, going to try and save the AWP and the AK for the next round.
Yeah, and it looks like they'll be able to do it, but Immortals, man, they stood strong. They worked the rounds exactly like they were in the past. The most previous round, they lost towards an outer split, but there, they got that pick at IV early on. One of the first times we've seen them get the opening kill, but in the other rounds where they had got the opening kill, they almost always converted them. So, you know, I think it's good to see them just go back to what works as opposed to appear to be so desperate to change it up for fear that SK will throw them some kind of curveball, you know. I think Immortals don't feel comfortable unless they are in their opponent's heads, you know. But the thing is that that's really shooting themselves in the foot, right? They have the aim to play the standard game, and they're on CT side. Why not play those advantages?
Oh, Henny has his crosshair perfectly placed, poised for the frag. It's Glaive that has his dancing shoes on. This is so scary to watch from his perspective, knowing what we know. And this could be a huge kill. It was the last time when Glaive died first, and he decides, nope, not feeling it. Waiting for maybe that push through Ivy from Immortals. And realized it wasn't forthcoming, just backing off. And also the economy from SK, they are going to be able to buy up fully both rounds coming up after this. There's no easy rounds for Immortals.
Right.
They're not going to break the economy here. This is the long way back.
I think Acilian has got dinked.
He did, yeah, down 60 through the Lucas about back for smoke. This is going to be the execute. It's forthcoming right here, right now. Lucas is in prime position to strike, and he whiffs to the first kill, but he's going to get the second one. Meanwhile, Moddy comes in for two, and again, SK now have the player advantage. And it's going to be on that man, Phelps, the top fragger for his team, the man that's been in the thick of the action. Showtime goes through the smoke, is looking for a second frag. And look at this movement, actually, from Valdi. He's going to be pushing through connector with the bomb towards B. And now it falls to Phelps, and it'll be fitting for Immortals if it was Phelps that clutched this, because he has been the man. Bomb planted. He seems to think this is the back of the site, but that's not the case. Drop down makes noise, and now Vald's gonna know he's on his way through. 5-7 not quite connecting. Meanwhile, though, watch out for threes. He's not even required. Vald is there, 16-13. And we've witnessed our first upset. SK take it.
Wow. An exciting match, and I think that's one of the more elite, unlikely upsets in general. Immortals unable to close it out after having, what was it, 10-6, I think, even winning the second pistol.